Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're going to evaluate without using a calculator first. So let's give it a try first, okay? So when you're given the question such as 15% of 40, now a lot of us will just grab the calculator right away and punch in the calculator, right? So there's actually some other ways we can actually figure it out without a calculator. So here we go, 15% of 40. So a couple ways we can do this is actually take the 0.15, take the decimal form of the 15% and times by 40. But the problem is, we still need a calculator to figure this one out, because what is it? We don't know, right? I mean, you're going to have to do your multiplication by hand. Now, I have a little trick right here. It's not really like a special trick, but it's probably an easier way to think of the question. So the 40 is what you're trying to figure out, but it's the 15% that you're trying to get from the 40. Now, instead of thinking about 15%, you're thinking it as 10% and a 5%, okay? Because if you add a 10 and 5 together, it is still 15%, right? Now, we're used to 10%. It's easier to think about because it's just, you know, one decimal away from the number. So if I said, what is a 10% of 40? Most of us were able to figure it out that it's just a 4, okay? Because the 10% of something is just one decimal to the left of that number, okay? So 10% of the 40 is just a 4, right? Now, what's the 5% of the 40? Well, if 10% is 4, 5% is only half of the 10%. So that makes it just a 2. So that means if I add up these 2% together, the 10 plus 5, which is 15%, and that's what the question wants you to figure out, it's just 4 plus 2 gives you just a 6. Okay? So let's go back to the original question right here. If I said that 15% of the 40, what is the answer? You would take the decimal form of the percentage by moving your decimal to the left. So you get yourself a 0.15. You take the 0.15, you times the 40, you get yourself just a 6. And magically, they are the same as if you do it by hand. Thanks for watching.